What's up, guys? It's Crazy Man here, and I don't want to do this, but I have to. This is going to be a rant video. I'm sick of it. In the background, for those of you who have nothing to watch or something, I'm just going to, like, make an army painter. But, you know, Dawn of War, right? Everyone says, oh, do more Dawn of War, you know. Do more Dawn of War. I want to see this. You guys better hope I never find your friggin' YouTube channel. Or your, not your YouTube channel, your Steam. Because if you play any other game other than Dawn of War, I'm gonna rip on you, okay? It's not okay to be a fanboy. It's okay to have preferences, right? I like Dawn of War as much as the next guy. You know, it's good to sit down and relax with. But when you sit here and you just say, oh, I just want to watch this Dawn of War video. Oh, I just want to watch this. You know, it hasn't been just my past video. It's been building up over time. People say, oh, you know, I only watch your Dawn of War videos. Why? Why? Are you only like, oh, Dawn of War, Dawn of War, Dawn of War. And why, for that matter, why are you even on YouTube? I mean, you should just be watching Dawn of War all the time. Or playing Dawn of War all the time, rather. Because that's really all that matters. You know what? It's annoying. If you're going to leave comments like that, then don't even bother to comment. Because it's annoying. I put effort into those other videos. I try with those other videos. I do stuff. For someone to just say, oh, you know, I only do this. I only watch this. You're a fanboy, and it's disgusting. But, I mean, it's so annoying just to see this. It's like, come on, guys. Open up. Opened up to another game. You know what? Tomorrow, I think I'm going to upload, maybe even later today, I'm going to upload a Killing Floor gameplay with 16 players, and I'm going to have a heck of a time doing it. And I know I'm not even going to probably scratch 100 views on it. Why? Because it's not Dawn of War. Because it's something new. It's something they have to figure out. Well, here's what I want to compare this to. The guys over at Machinima. I'm sending these videos into them, and I can guarantee you, I'm not the only one who's done it, but I'm sure they don't want to accept, because is it really worth learning a whole new game and all the units and all the abilities and all the times and all that just for a handful of commentators? No, it's not. So, I don't know why you guys are pushing Dawn of War. It's not a highly successful game. It's not the next new thing. And guess what? If Space Marine fails, which I have a somewhat of an idea that it might, and guess what? Dawn of War is going to go down even further. And if Dawn of War 3 fails, guess what? This channel's done. Because I based on Dawn of War. So that's why I'm not doing that. Because if I base it on StarCraft, guess what? If the next StarCraft game fails, I'm done. That's why I emphasize so much. It's a gaming channel, not just Dawn of War. I understand Dawn of War is my most successful video. But if I just base it on that, and something fails, I'm done. That's it. Might as well just close it down. Because, you know, no one's going to watch it. You guys might say you might, but that's what? 300 subscribers? I want to grow. You know, I don't want to be at 300 subscribers forever. I don't want to sit there and... And I certainly don't want to do Call of Duty commentaries for a living. That is just frustrating. Call of Duty is a frustrating game, but it's fun. You know, I'll upload some of those later too, but not just, you know, just not every video is Call of Duty or something like that, because that's really stupid. But I guess that's pretty much it for this. I really don't know what else to say other than, you know, open yourself up. Oh, and I want to list off another thing: the top two guys from the Dawn of War tournament. Petros and Candyman. I just want to list off some statistics that I just recently looked up. Petros, you know, a lot of people say he's really good at Dawn of War. He is really good at Dawn of War. Good player. Solid player. But you didn't know he has more hours into Modern Warfare 2 than he does in Dawn of War. Just saying. Candyman. The other player. 42 hours into Knights of the Old Republic, 60 hours into Star Wars Gold Edition. I don't even know what it is. Something, I don't know. I totally just went brain dead there. You wanna know how many hours Petros has into Modern Warfare 2? I'm gonna throw it out there right now. 599.8. And I applaud him for that. Because that means he's an actual gamer. He opens himself up. People who just sit here and play Dawn of War. I think this is kind of the fail. The failing of the series. It's starting now, I think. Because you look at how it has just declined. And I think Chaos Rising might be the main downfall of the series. It might have been. Because you look at Dawn of War 2. The base game. Very successful. Lots of people joined it. Okay. But the Dawn of War 1 fans did not like it. They like the base building. They like their strategizing, and I personally like that too, but I'm open to options. So I got into this, you know, I started playing this, and wow, this is really fun, you know. And then Chaos Rising came out. Possibly the worst expansion I have ever played. One race, 13, I can't remember if it's 11 or 13 new missions, a couple new multiplayer maps. Couple new Last Stand heroes. That's it. For $30. The only reason I pre-ordered it was because I got Saints Row 2 free with it, and then I realized that game is garbage. And then now Retribution comes out. Well, that Chaos Rising just lost him a whole bunch of fans. You kidding me? Who wants to pay $30 for an expansion that's got a couple new campaign missions? What if you're not even into the campaign? Then what? Oh, you're screwed. You got a couple new multiplayer maps. One new race. Now, Retribution got a little bit right. It did a little better. You know, it introduced another new race. 6 new campaigns, which all have the same missions because they're just slacking or like that. I don't know. But, and then a new Last Stand map. A new Last Stand hero. It's more multiplayer maps. That's better, right? This is better than Chaos Rising. But by then, the damage is done. People who bought Chaos Rising and were all excited for that are like, screw this. I ain't gonna show off another $30 just for another garbage experience, because they don't know. They don't know that this game is better than Chaos Rising. They don't know that. And why should they expect it? But, and then that's where, not to mention, a little game in 2010 came out called StarCraft 2. I don't know if people are going to say, oh, I hate StarCraft 2. Why? Did you not enjoy base building? Did you not enjoy... In my opinion, this is actually not even a true strategy game. StarCraft is a true strategy game. This is more of a strategy, action, hybrid, you know. There is strategy in it, but nowhere near the amount of a StarCraft. I think these are the two major franchises left. Actually, there's 3 major strategy franchises. StarCraft, Command & Conquer, and Dawn of War. That's just my opinion. I think that Dawn of War is kind of maybe the weakest of the three, but a lot of people are going to disagree with me after Command & Conquer 4. I thought it was alright, but I know it's a whole other topic in its own, so... Anyway, if you guys enjoyed the video, leave a comment on what you want to see next. Maybe that Killing Floor 16-player multiplayer thing could happen. That game is fun, guys. Give it a chance. Give games a chance. Just sit here and say, oh, it's not Retribution. I don't like it. Because then you're a fanboy, and fanboys suck. Say it right now. I hate fanboys. I have an Xbox 360 right over there. I love that. I love my PC. I love my PSP. You know, I got the 3 major contenders, except for the PS3, which... But I have the 3... I have Microsoft... And I have Sony. Those are the, and I mean, 3 consoles that are totally different. Actually, 3 systems, I guess it would be. They're totally different. And yet, somehow, I enjoy them all. How is that? Anyway. As I said earlier, I should have wrapped it up earlier. Leave a comment down below on what you want to see next. If it's Dawn of War, I'm just going to remove your comment, because you're a fanboy. And open yourself up. Come on, guys. Open yourself up to new games. Because Dawn of War... How many times have I yawned in Dawn of War? Plenty. You know why? Because Rarely do you get those epic battles. Rarely. Especially in public matches. Look at how many players are online. 3,000? You serious? There are hundreds, if not millions, on StarCraft every day. Why would I scramble to find a match in Dawn of War when I can just easily go over to StarCraft and play that? Or why would I try and scramble here? Why would I make it harder on myself? I don't know. It's okay to like the game. I like the game. I have fun with it, but if I just do Dawn of War all the time, the franchise will eventually fail. Every franchise does. Okay? I just want you guys to know that every franchise fails. I know a lot of people are going to jump on Command & Conquer for this video, but anyway, leave a comment down below on what you think, what you want to see next. Like I said, if it's just Dawn of War, I'm just going to remove your comment because I'm getting kind of bored of this game. If you try a new strategy, you most likely fail. Your opponent just spams the most powerful unit in the game or whatever, but I'll see you guys later. Have a nice day. Maybe expect another video later today. Bye-bye.